In the last video, we learned that it can be problematic to pass down props through several levels in the component tree. We also learned that the context API will help solve that problem. In this video, let's see how the context API was used before the introduction of hooks. Now, I'm not going to completely go into the details of the implementation, but we will understand how the code works to be able to compare and contrast with the code we write in the next video. If you want a complete understanding of the context API, I would recommend you watch the videos from my React for Beginners series. Alright, let's begin. For this demo, I will only consider the rightmost part of the component tree, that is, components C, E, and F. Our goal is to pass the username prop from app component and read that prop in component F using context. To get us started, I have already created the components and nested them at the appropriate level. In app component, we have component C. Within component C, we have component E, and finally, within component E, we have component F. Now, let us understand how to get data from the app component to component F using context. There are three steps to implement when making use of context. Step 1 is to create the context, and I will create it in the app component. Const useContext is equal to react.createContext. Second step, we need to provide this context with a value, and the provider must wrap the children components for the value to be available. So we wrap component C. UserContext.provider. Component C is going to be a child to this provider, and we need to provide a context value. Value is equal to Vishwas, which is the username. The third and final step is to consume the context value. So from app component, let us export the context, and in component F, let us import it. Next, in the JSX, we need to make use of the render props pattern to get hold of the value passed by the context. So useContext.consumer. The context provides us with a username, and we are going to return useContextValue is the user. If we now save the file and take a look at the browser, we can see the expected output, useContextValue Vishwas. The value being passed from the provider is being consumed using the render props pattern in the required component. The context feature itself is great, as you can see, but the way to consume it is slightly more verbose than we would like it to be. And to be honest, if we have just the one context, it would still be fine. But let's see how to consume multiple context values. Back in app component, I'm going to create another context. Channel context is going to be react.createContext. And now let's provide this context with a value of code evolution. We can provide multiple context values by simply adding the providers at each level. So within user context, channel context.provider, component C is going to be nested within channel context. And the value is going to be the string code evolution. The final part is to consume this, and this is the part where it starts getting ugly. In component F, we have user context, which gives us access to the user, and within the function body, we need to yet again use the render props pattern to get hold of the channel name. So we are going to import user context and channel context from app.js. And now within the function body, we are going to return channelContext.consumer, render props pattern again, which gives us access to the channel name value. And then we can return this div tag. User context value, comma, channel context value. This is going to be channel. If we now take a look at the browser, we are displaying values from both the contexts, Vishwas and CodeEvolution. So the code works, but it is not necessarily the most readable code. Just to consume two values, there is just so much of nesting. If only there was a better way to consume the context values. This is where the useContext hook comes to our support. The useContext hook lets you consume context values in a more simpler way. Let's learn that approach in the next video. Thank you guys for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next one.